So someone wanted to know, can afferent disease cause light near dissociation of the pupils? And the answer, of course, is yes. And the reason is, dissociation means that they're not associated, and that's because the light and the near pathway separate out at two different locations. And so because of that separation, we can have dissociation between the light and the near pathway. And because the light pathway has both an afferent and an efferent component, it can definitely dissociate from the near pathway. But in order to understand any of that, you have to know the topography, which is place, of the afferent and the efferent pathway. So the light enters into the eye, it strikes the retinal elements and the ganglion cell, it travels in the optic nerve, the temporal fibers uncross, the nasal fibers cross into the optic tract, but instead of going to the lateral geniculate nucleus, the pupil pathways on the afferent side travel to the dorsal midbrain. And at the level of the dorsal midbrain, the pretectal nuclei, this is the tectum, which is the roof of the fourth ventricle, talks to the Ettinger-Westphal nucleus in the third nerve for the pupil, but it talks to both pupils. And then the efferent pathway is carried on the third nerve to its ganglion, a parasympathetic ganglion called the ciliary ganglion, and then the postganglionic nerve to the iris. So this is the efferent pathway. It's carried on the third nerve, and the afferent pathway is retina, optic nerve, chiasm, tract, pretectal nuclei. And so the near lives somewhere up here in the rostral thalamomesencephalic junction. The near pathway has a triad: convergence, accommodation, and pupillary meiosis. That is completely independent of the light pathway. So the near pathway can talk directly to the Ettinger-Westphal nucleus without the light pathway. And that means if you have bilateral, no light perception vision from a bilateral optic neuropathy, you can still activate the near response and get light near dissociation of both pupils, because you don't need the light pathway to activate the near pathway. So can afferent disease cause a light near dissociation? Yes. How? It dissociates the light in the near pathway because the near pathway actually can talk to the efferent pupillary pathway without the light at all. And that means someone who's totally blind can look at the tip of their nose, cross their eyes, and constrict their pupil, even if they're no light perception blind in both eyes. So you need to know the topographical anatomy of the afferent and the efferent pathway to answer a question like this. Can afferent disease alone cause light near dissociation? Answer, yes.